Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at taming your apps in iOS 7. So iOS 7 includes several functions that allow you to figure out what your apps are doing, how much storage they're using, how much data they're using over your mobile connection, and whether they're using location services at the moment. Some of this stuff is old, some of this stuff is new. Let's take a look. So to get to all this, you're going to go into the Settings app. Once you're in the Settings app, you can go various different places. Let's start by going to General and then going to Usage. And under that, you're going to see how much storage you have available at the top, but then the list is going to quickly expand and you're going to see all of these apps here. And it's going to be sorted by the apps that use the most space. So for instance, Audible, which stores audiobooks, is using the most space for me, which makes sense. I've got a lot of audiobooks in there. I can see GarageBand, Spotify, etc. I can tap on each one of these and I could see a breakdown. Usually most apps just say everything's documents and data, but sometimes you get a further breakdown. Like for instance, if I were to look in the podcast app, you can see that it actually shows me a video podcast and audio podcasts, and not only can I see which ones are there, but I can actually delete them. I can swipe right to left and delete a podcast right here from inside of Settings. Of course, I could also do that inside of the app. For most of these apps, you're going to have to go in, for instance, in Audible. There's nothing you can do here. You're going to have to go into the Audible app, and that's where you can decide which books you want to remove from your iPhone. Say ones I've already finished but I forgot to remove, and that'll clear up some space. Most of these apps are going to be like that. For instance, in Pages, it'll show me it's using the space, but I can't do anything here. I can go into Pages and I can remove documents in there and delete them. So this is how you figure out what's using space on your iPhone or iPad. So now let's take a look at location services. So inside of Settings, you go down to Privacy and then Location Services. And location services means basically using the GPS on your phone. Of course, a lot of times it's not using GPS, it's using Wi-Fi or cell tower signals to figure out where you are. And you can figure out which apps actually have that turned on so they can access it. And you can turn some off so that they can't access it. And you also can see arrows next to them. For instance, Camera's got a gray arrow next to it, while Cycle Meter, an app that tracks people while they run or bike, has a purple arrow next to it. I just turn that on so it should be actively tracking my location. And you can scroll through the list here. And at the bottom it tells you what these arrows mean. So basically a gray one means that it recently used location services. So you expect Camera, yeah, if I took a picture in the last 24 hours, then it accessed the current location. And this is not really going to wear down the battery if it's just occasionally accessing it when you do an action. Purple, though, will wear down the battery because it's actively polling it. It's using it right now. But of course, that's exactly what I want Cycle Meter to do. However, this can be useful if, say, I finished my bike ride and I've forgotten to turn it off and I'm trying to figure out why the battery is draining on my phone. I can see that that's what's using GPS now. I can also see what other apps are using it now. Maybe there's some app that I'm not using or I didn't expect to use GPS that I can see that is, and I can maybe stop using that app if it's causing me trouble. Also at the bottom you can see apps that use geofence, which are things like, you know, reminders, remind you to do something when you get home or when you get to work. It's going to have a kind of outlined arrow there. So you can find out which apps you have that are using GPS, and you can actually switch them off or maybe perhaps go into the app and modify their functionality so they use less battery. So here's a new feature of iOS 7 that's very useful. If you've ever gone through your monthly mobile bandwidth allotment, or perhaps gotten a bill that's shown that you used a lot of data, and you want to figure out why, what app is actually using all this data? Well, with iOS 7 you can figure that out. All you need to do in Settings is go into Cellular, and it will show you underneath all of this, use cellular data for, and it shows you all of your apps. And fortunately, this isn't sorted in any order, but you can see exactly how much data each app has used, and you can figure out which ones may be using more than you'd like to. You can also turn off the access to cellular data for certain apps. So for instance, if you've got a game that uses a lot of cellular data and you want to remember not to play it while you're over cellular, or if we're not to update graphics or something, you can turn it off here. And you can also look through this list here. The list is short, and then at the bottom you've got system services, which you can go into and see data used by the system and a breakup of it. So for instance, I can look through here and see that things like Gmail's using surprisingly little data. and some games are using very little data, but I can look and find my music app, and my music app I can see is using 247 megs. And the answer to that is, of course, because I'm using iTunes Radio, so I could expect that one to be a little high. But others, not so much, and I really can get a good handle of what the worst offenders are using this. Another thing I like is under System Services, one of the things it shows you is personal hotspot. So if you use a personal hotspot and you're curious how much data you're using as opposed to using other cellular data, it breaks it down for you here. And of course at the bottom of the screen you'll notice a reset statistics button. So these numbers are just going to keep piling up until you hit this. And once you do, everything zeroes out there. So now I can begin tracking to see over the next few days which apps are using the most data. So there are three different ways that you can tame the apps on your iOS device. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched. And go to that page. Underneath the video you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.